A warm good evening to all the doctors. Myself, Dr. Sirisha Sridhar Anishetty, MS Prasuti Tantra Sriroga, presently working as Associate Professor in Prasuti Sriroga Department, Ananta Lakshmi Government Ayurvedic Medical College, Warangal, Telangana State. First of all, I sincerely use this opportunity to congratulate and convey thanks to Team Jignyasa for a good collective work and for this opportunity. I'm here to present regarding the female infertility and its Ayurvedic management. As you all know, the incidence of infertility is increasing in day-to-day life, and there are many causes for the female infertility, and treating a female infertility case is a challenge to the Ayurvedic physicians, because the infertility couple first approaches, most of the infertility couple approaches allopathic doctors and receives the allopathic medication. After long receive of those medication, not getting the expected result, they'll turn to the other systems like Ayurveda, homeopathy, etc. So they'll come to the Ayurvedic physician with a huge file in their hands and a lot of depression in their minds. So handling the female infertility case becomes a challenge to the Ayurvedic physician. So as you all know, motherhood, God could not be everywhere, so he created mother. Mother, and motherhood is a dream of each and every woman after the marriage. Simply, in this presentation, I would like to focus a light on the causes of infertility and importance of the vata in causing infertility, role of vata causing in infertility, and importance of basti in treatment of the female infertility. And at the end, I would like to share a few cases which are managed with Ayurvedic treatment and the results we got, along with the reports and documentation I would like to present. So simply to define, the infertility is a failure to achieve conception by a mature aged couple with a regular unprotected intercourse even after the 1 year of marital life, or in other words, which is the definition accepted by all the doctors all over the world. And infertility is a disease of the reproductive system defined by the failure to achieve a clinical pregnancy after 12 months of marital life with a regular unprotected sexual intercourse, which is defined by the World Health Organization. And simply to speak, infertility is the inability of a sexually active non-consenting couple to achieve pregnancy in 1 year. And as you know, the infertility is of two types, primary and the secondary infertility. Failure to achieve conception even one time is called as the primary infertility. Failure to achieve the conception second time is called the secondary infertility. There is a lot of literature available in the classical texts regarding the causes and the types of infertility. And apart from, a lot of treatments are also described. So we are not going deep into that. And for the next slide, so first we'll see the causes of infertility. According to the modern aspect, the causes of infertility are described like this. That is, the uterine factors accounts about 10%, ovarian factors 30-40%, tubal factors are 25-35%, cervical factors 5%, and endometrial factors are 1-10%. Here, these all are also explained in the Ayurveda in different forms. The next slide will see the causes of infertility according to the Ayurveda. There is an elaborated description of the causes of infertility in Ayurveda. In this regard, I would like to quote four shlokas. Among them, the first shloka is, next slide, that is a yoni pradoshan. Previous slide. Yoni pradoshan manasu abhitapascha shukrasruk ahara vihara doshat akala yogat balasankshayatcha garbham chirat vindati saprachapi. This is a shloka from the Charaka. So here, in this one shloka, Charaka has explained many causes of infertility. For example, if we'll see the yoni pradosha. Yoni pradosha can be the yoni, the one term denotes the entire reproductive system. In this, the uterine causes, cervical causes, endometrial causes, all could be taken in the yoni pradosha. So here, the congenital deformity, defects of the uterus, such as the arcuate uterus, didelphous uterus, bicornuate, unicolis, bicolis, septate uterus, presence of the vaginal septums, or atresia of the reproductive organs, these all could be included in the yoni pradosha, and different types of gynecological diseases or causing the damage to the yoni as a functionally or anatomically, all could be included. Means the functional and anatomical aspects and acquired defects and the congenital defects of the uterus, endometrium, cervix, vagina could be placed in the yoni pradosha. Next is the manasu abhitapascha. Manasu abhitapascha is related to the mind, that is the psychological status of the women. Thus, as you know, the psychological imbalance leads to the hormonal imbalance. As the hormones are responsible for the preparation of the endometrium, for ovulation, for regular menstrual cycles, and if conceived, to maintain the pregnancy, the hormones are essential. As you all know, this total mechanism is dependent on the invisible interplay of the hormones. The total menstrual cycle is dependent on the invisible interplay of the hormones. So here the psychological imbalance leads to the hormonal imbalance, which indirectly acts as a cause of the infertility. That's why in Ayurvedic texts it's described saumanasyam garbhadharananam. So psychological balance is very essential to achieve the conception. And coming on to the shukra doshas, shukra asruk aharam, here the shukra dosha pertaining to the male, that is a sperm disorders can be taken. But coming on to the, there is another concept of the stri shukra, anta shukra and the bahish shukra. Here the bahish shukra of the in females could be may be considered as exudates into the path during the act due to the excitement, that is the secretions from the glands which are present in the path that maintains the pH and provides the lubrication, which provides the favorable condition for favorable media for the sperm to maintain its motility, so that it can easily move and reach the cervix and pass through it through the cavity and reaches the ovum and fertilize it. Whereas anta shukra is may be considered as it maintains the dhat poshana, and according to that the shukra is spread all over the body and maintains it. So here the anta shukra can be considered as the hormones which are responsible for the total reproductive function here. So next is the astruk dosha. Astruk dosha is the menstrual disorders. So here the menstrual irregularities, astruk may be considered as the menstruation. So the menstrual irregularities are the astruk may be considered as the ovum, the defect in the ovulation, are the quality less ovum released, which are included in the astruk doshas. Next is the ahara vihara doshas. As you all know, ahara is the one among the trayopastambas, which is responsible for the healthiness of the body, which decides the psychology as well as the body health and the mental health of the human being. So here the improper food intake, which aggravates the doshas, which leads to the different types of diseases. These aggravated doshas, when reaches the reproductive system, it causes the dysfunction. There is a functional disturbance, so which leads to the infertility, and malnutrition, which leads to the undevelopment or the less development of the needed dhatus. And the vihara doshas, improper activity is also aggravates the doshas, which is indirectly responsible for the infertility. And akala yoga, here we can consider it is a lack of sex education by the couple, not knowing the fertile period and non-fertile period. So because of the lack of knowledge of fertile and non-fertile period, they are together in a non-fertile period and away from each other in the fertile period. So this is called the Akala Yoga. And next one is a Bala Sankshaya. Achha. Bala Kshaya is the Bala can be taken as a Shariraka Bala and the Garbhadharana Bala. Here the Shariraka Bala, that is a physical strength. Though the she is physically fit and is very good at her physical strength. But Garbhadharana Bala is less because of the local infections or the yoni shushkas, the dryness of the vagina, or due to frigidity and fear. What will happen next? These causes the frigidity in the female. Because of that and the local infections which are causing the itching, burning, dyspareunia, because of these, some sort of fear is developed in the patient so that she shows the frigidity. That decreases the Garbhadharana Bala. So, these are the causes. And next, the second shloka I would like to quote is the Artha Vahedve Tayor Mulam Garbhashayam Artha Vahinya Damanyascha. Tatra Vidhasya Vandhyatvam. This is a mistakenly typed. That is a Vandhyatvam Maituna Sahishnuta Arthavanasasya. Here, Mula is the Garbhashaya and Artha Vahinya Damanyasya. Here, the Artha Vahinya. Arthava may be considered as the ovum. The ovum carrying channels are the Garbhashaya Nalikas. They are the fallopian tubes. Here, injury to the Artha Vahashrutas leads to the dyspareunia. And Vandhyatva and Arthavanasasya means irregular menstruation or defect in the ovulation. And Maituna Sahishnita is a dyspareunia condition which is because of the infectious status. And Vandhyatva, which as the ovum carrying channels are disturbed, they got the Vaigunyas. So the carrying of the ovum is not possible, so that leads to the Vandhyatva. So the same shloka is explained by the Kashyapa also. Here the Arthava Shrotha Avarodha is happening, which may be considered as a tubal blockage. Mainly the yoni vapas, the Aticharana, Aticharana, Pariplutha, Upaplutha, like PID correlated, all the yoni vapas are responsible for the dosha, aggravated doshas, which are the Vata, Kapha and Pitta. That is because of Vata, Sankocha and Shofa with the Kapha and Paka with the Pitta are the main symptoms seen. Here the Shrotho Sangha type of Vaigunya happens and Shrotho Varodha is seen. That is a tubal blockage. We'll see. If we'll go to the modern causes of the tubal blockage, the tubal blockage is seen in primary infertility and in secondary infertility cases also. In primary infertility cases, 16-20% and in secondary infertility cases, it is about 25-30%. Here the common causes of the tubal blockage are the infectious status and previous tubal surgeries, PIDs, pelvic inflammatory disease and suffering with STDs, sexually transmitted diseases and congenital abnormalities of the tube, and congenitally there may be the possibility of the blockage, and post-abortal status, puerperal infections, tubal endometriosis and spasm and torch infections, especially the gonococcal and the tubercular infections are more responsible for the tubal blockage. So there is no ovum transmission here, so that the sperm can't, as there is a blockage, the sperm can't reach the ovum, there is no fertilization, so infertility we'll see. So next shloka is as a complication of the yoni vapas. If the yoni vapas are not treated properly, as a complication of the yoni vapas, the infertility results. Na shukram dharayeti. So here Bir dosha yoni rupa drutaha. Here the patient who is suffering with the yoni vapas, in chronicity, what happens, the total yoni got disturbed. That yoni na shukram dharayet, it can't hold the sperm. So tasmat garbham na grunha, that's why the women can't get the concealment here. So dasmat garbham na grihnati, so she can't achieve the conception here as a complication of the untreated yoni vyapads. And the one more shloka I would like to quote is, while explaining the vata vyadhi samanya lakshan, Charaka in his in the 28th chapter, he explains that the garbha shukra rajo nashah spandanam gatra suptata, the aggravated vata disturbs all over the body, all the organs, and reaches the reproductive system and causes the garbha shukra rajo nashah. Here the garbhanasha, shukranasha and the rajonasha means the disturbance in the menstrual cycle, disturbance in the ovulation, and in males disturbance in means a defective spermatogenesis at the destruction of the sperm, and if luckily she conceives also, that garbha destroyed by the aggravated vata. Vandyam nashtarthavam vidyati is explained by the Sushruta. Here the nashtarthava, that is a defective in the ovulation or anovulatory cycles. So the last shloka explains that evam yonisha shuddha, in the shuddha yoni only the garbham vindati yoshitaha, in the shuddha yoni only the shuddha yoni only can help the shukra properly, and garbham, the achievement of the conception is possible when the yoni is shuddha. Next, so importance of the vata dosha. Here the vata is explained the important among the three doshas, because vayurgati, it has the chalatva, it is able to move, whereas the pittam pangu kapham pangu, so they are unable to move. To carry them, the vata, the mobility of the vata is essential. Here it maintains all over the body. Ividhi shloka, vayur vayur balam vayur vayur dhata sharirenam vayur vishvamidam sarvam prabhur vayuscha kirtitaha. So this is the importance given to the vayu. With the vata only the ayu is decided, that is the lifespan is decided, and it is responsible for all the karmas in the body. Avyahata gatiryasya sthanastaha prakrutostitaha, when it is normally functioning, then it performs all the functions of the body. Vayu syat adhikam jivet vitaroga vitaroha, it prevents all the diseases. There is no disease seen when the vayu is in its normal status and lives for 100 years. That is explained by the charaka. And here one thing we have to remember, the functions of the apana vata, which we'll study in the first year of BAMS, the shloka from the Ashtanga Hridaya. अपानो पानगः शोनिवस्त मेड्रोर गोचरः शुक्रार्थव शक्रुन्मोत्र गर्भ निष्क्रमण क्रियाः. हियर द अपानवाता इज मेनली रेस्पॉन्सिबल फॉर द शुक्र आर्तव शक्रुन्मोत्र गर्भ निष्क्रमण क्रियाः. सो फॉर आर्तव, फॉर द रेगुलर मेंस्ट्रुअल साइकिल्स, एंड फॉर द ओव्यूलेशन, एंड फॉर द गर्भ निष्क्रमण, द अपानवाता प्लेस वेरी इंपॉर्टेंट रोल. गर्भ निष्क्रमण इज अ फुल टर्म बेबी एक्सपल फुल टर्म फ्यूटर एक्सपर्शन ज्यूरिंग द लेबर. अपार्ट फ्रॉम दैट, द गर्भ निष्क्रमण कैन बी एक्सप्लेन्ड एज सून एज अ फर्टिलाइजेशन हैपन, इट्स अ वन डे आर द टू डे, सेकंड डे आर द थर्ड डे, इट इज कॉल्ड एज अ गर्भ. सो द गर्भ विच इज फॉर्म्ड इन द गर्भाशय नलिका इन द आर्तवाहिनी द मणि, दट इज इन द फेलोपियन ट्यूब, should be transferred to the uterine cavity. Here the garbha nishkramana from the fallopian tube to the uterine cavity, this is also taken as a garbha nishkramana. Otherwise it will get implanted there and it results in the tubal ectopic pregnancy. So this is also the function of the apanavata. Pravartako cheshtaha, here all the functions are because of vata, that is all the cheshta, sarva cheshta samoho is because of the vata. Here, if we'll see the importance of vata in short, that is first starting in the fertilization, first starting the union of the male and female. Here, tatra stri purusha samyoge teja shariraad vayu ridhirayati tatas tejo anilaha sannipata shukram shutam. So here, the falling of the shukra in the vagina is the function of the vata, and yonim abhiprapathyate samsrujyate chartavena, it maintains its mobility and reaches the ovum, that is also the function of the vata. Meanwhile it is fallen in the vagina where the ovulation is happened, that is bedhana karma, the rupture of the maturing follicles is the karma because of vata, and the rupture of the micro muscles, the rupture of the micro muscles, that is a bedana, is also the samsra vyasa vyada swapa sada rukto, the bedana. So the bedana karma is because of the vata. So the ovum which is released with the ovarian fimbria near to the ovary, catch it, grahana, is also the function of the vata, and it is transmitted to the fallopian tube, that is also the function of aspiration movements, ciliary movements, are the chaladva, that is also the function of the vata. As the shukra ascends and reaches the ovum, and it unites with the ovum and unites with the ovum, unites with the ovum. So that is the samyoga. That is also the vata, and that is also the because of vata. And one more, when it reaches the ovum, it dilutes the dissolves the wall of the ovum and results in the and enter into it, and it is surrounded. Pravishta madram bijam hi raktena parivesthayet, raktena parivesthayet. Here the it loses the tail, that is also the function of the vata, and it entirely surrounded by the bija. Here the pravishta madram bijam hi raktena parivesthayet. Bijam here is the sperm and rakta is the ovum, so it is entirely surrounded. The parivesthanam is also a karma, which is because of the vata. After that, it should be transported to the uterine cavity. That is also the ciliary movements and aspiration movements of the tube. Here also the chalatva, that is also the function of the vata. Where it reaches, gets implantation, and where the decidual preparation is there, that all are because of the vata. And formation of villi, formation of placenta with the primary, secondary, tertiary villi, etc. This is all the means growth of growth of the mesoderm into it, and then the vascular involvement, etc. These all are because of the vata, and this total mechanism is under the control of the prakruta vata karma. So when the vata is prakruta, then only it is able to perform these all functions. If it is get disturbed among these all the functions, any one of may be disturbed, which results in the infertility. So here, maintaining the prakrita karmas of vata is essential to achieve the conception. And it is considered that is the basti is the best treatment for the vata doshas. Means here the basti is, Bela says the basti is acts as a nectar for the infertility women. So here vandyanam shatapakena shoditanam yadhakramam balatailena dehyaha shudbhaste. Here the shatapaka balataila is considered to be the best for treating the vandyas. And in this next sloka, the shatavari gudichi, the preparation cures the vandyanam rakta gulminana. So it is the basti administered in the female infertility patient. And jivanti madanam, the shloka from the Charka Siddhisthana. Here also he says that the mutra reto rajo doshan haret. Here all the rajo doshas, means defective ovulation or the irregular menstrual cycles, can be corrected with this haret adumasanam. With this anuvasanavasti, we can correct them. So maintaining the vata in a proper and the vitiated vata should be corrected to achieve the proper functioning of the vata, which is responsible for the conception. So these are the common medicine. This is about the importance and the causes of infertility. Before going to the treatment, I would like to say few things. When you are going to treat a infertility patient, first you have infertility patient, few things should be remembered by the vaidya. That is, while treating the infertility patient, both the partners are treated simultaneously, and counseling should be given to both the partners, and assurance should be given, because already they are in a psychological disturbance. As we are the social beings, they are affected with the words of the other people, and that comparing with the other couples, that they are not having the progeny, so they are already depressed. So we should not speak any negative words to them, and in a soft manner listen them patiently whatever they will explain, and don't discourage them. And while growing through the reports, discuss them and reveal the appropriate cause, which you feel this is the cause, because of this cause you are not getting the concealment. So explain it clearly, and explain them the treatment also, the oral medication which you are giving and the procedures which we are going to perform in them. which we are making them to undergo, how they work and how they result. This all should be explained to the patient. Apart from that, you have to advise the diet. In irregular cycles, delayed cycles, we have to advise the patient what is the diet to be taken. So, Arthavajanana drugs should be advised there, which would not aggravate the remaining doshas. And explain the need of tolerance and the patience while receiving the treatment, and tell them appropriate time about the 6 to 9 months, or depending upon the cause, how much time it will take for the treatment to achieve the conception. That you have to explain them clearly so that they will have the faith in you and you in the system. So apart from that, the common treatments which I used to treat the infertility patients at Sadhguru Hospital are the Kanchanara Gugulu Dashamula Arishta, Garbhadharani Vati, Tochnil Capsules Chandraprabha Vati, Brahmi Vati, and in few cases the Nishamalaki was also used where the blood sugar levels are increased and the non-diabetic cases are there. And Ayogabhasya and Uttarbhasya are the common procedures which are used for that. For yoga basi, Dhanvantaram Thailam, Sahasraradi Thailam, Shirabala Thailam, and Kashayas are Dashmula Kashayam, Rasnadi Kashayam, Sahasraradi Kashayam, Varunadi Kashayam in few patients are used. And Uttar Basi, Kshara Thailam is used for especially the tubal blockage cases, and Bala Thailam at the end of tubal blockage cases, the last cycle was given with the Bala Thailam, and Bala Thailam is given in endometrial insufficiency and in most of the unexplained infertility cases, the Bala Thailam Uttarvasi given a very good results, and Dhanvantaram Thailam are used for the Uttarvasi. So these are the cases I would like to show you. So here this is a female case of 21 years age with a marital life of 3 years, and she received approximately 6 months of allopathic treatment. Later she was unable to cope up with the medication as she suffered with the hyperacidity, etc. symptoms, headache, etc. So she stopped and she approached for the Ayurvedic treatment. So this is a case, congenital situs inversus, the dextrocardial placed patient is there, and on findings she came to us with the regular menstrual cycles. And going through the repairs, it's found that the bulky left ovary and bilateral polycystic ovarian disease, and the patient is a torch positive. So here the patient was started the oral medication for the first month. Now she was given in Chandraprabhavati Dashamula Arishta Tochnil capsules, and in the second month she was treated with the Tochnil capsules, Dashamula Arishta, Garbhadharini Vati and Aloes compound. And next month she was planned for the Yogabhasthi. One cycle of Yogabhasthi was given in the patient with the Dhanvantaram Thailam and Dashamula Kashayam. Later planned for the Uttarvasthi. Two cycles of Uttarvasthi was given with a 101 Avartita Bala Thaila. After that, she got a cycle, normal cycle in the successive month, and in the successive month, she missed a period and she got conceived. Here you can see. And now she delivered also. So here you can see. So the patient has got conceived, and later she delivered in the last month. Next, this is a patient of age 30 years, and she has a fibroids. She with a marital life of 5 years, she received the allopathic treatment for 2 years. After that, she stopped she became obese, and she is a known case of hypothyroidism. And headache, hair fall, other complications she was having. So she stopped the allopathic medication. And after stopping the medication, after the 3 months, she got the menorrhagia, dysmenorrhea conditions. So she approached the Ayurvedic treatment for the Ayurvedic treatment.
this is a primary infertility case. She was having 3 fibroids in the uterus and left ovarian cyst and known case of hypothyroidism. So first she was treated with the Utrex tablets, which is not mentioned here, and Nakesar preparation to control the menorrhagia and dysmenorrhea, and Kanchana Ragugulu. These three are given, and Varunadi Kashayam is also given to the patient, which is not mentioned here. Kanchana Ragugulu, Utrex, Nakesar preparation and Varunadi Kashayam was first given to the patient in the first month. In the second month, she said that menstrual flow is normal and she doesn't have that intensity of the dysmenorrhea. And in the second cycle, she was planned for the Yogabhasthi. One cycle of Yogabhasthi was given with the Kshira Taila plus Dhanvantari Taila together and Dashmul Kashaya. After that, and oral medication in the second month was given the Kanchana Ragugulu, Dashamula Arishta, Garbhadharani Vati and Brahmi Vati, because she was in a depressive condition. And Brahmi Vati is very good in a shows very good action in controlling the psychological imbalances, as well as the Brahmi is placed in the Prajasthapana, first in the Prajasthapana drugs. So it promotes the favorable conditions for the concealment also. So in the second month, she was treated with the Kanchana Ragugulu, Dashamula Arishta, Utrex, Brahmi Vati, Garbhadharini Vati, and Nakesha preparation was continued. And in the third month, she was planned for the Uttarvasthi. The two cycles of Uttarvasthi was given with the Kshara Tailam. And later, because of lockdown, she didn't come. And the next cycle, she got normal with the reduced intensity of the dysmenorrhea and normal flow in the menstruation. And after getting the normal cycle, in the next month, she missed the period. And on USG, you can see the two fibroids disappeared and one is still remaining of size 24x19 mm in the posterior myometrium. So she is in 8 weeks and she is continuing her pregnancy. Now she is safe and good. So the next patient is a 26 years old. This is a case of secondary infertility. In the first pregnancy, she got aborted. At that time, she was about 22 years. Means 4 years back, she got the first pregnancy and got aborted. And she didn't conceive. So this is a case of secondary infertility. She received the allopathic treatment. She underwent the IUI also 2 times. And received a lot of hormones. While going through the reports, she came to us after stopping the medication of allopathy, means undergoing the 2 times of IUI. Later she got the disturbed menstrual cycles, irregular menstrual cycle. So she stopped the allopathic medication and took a time of 6 months gap, and then she approached the Ayurvedic for the Ayurvedic treatment. So here, on going through the investigations with the reports with her, it is found that the ovarian cyst of 39x38 mm and endometrial hypertrophy is observed, and polycystic ovarian syndrome and non-ovulatory cycles. These all are noted, and apart from this, the right tubal blockage. Here you can see in the report placed side, that is a PCOS, and in the second here you can see the endometrial hypertrophy and the right tubal blockage is seen, and one more is the non-ovulatory cycles with a hemorrhagic cyst is present in the right ovary. So these are the findings. Later, first she was given the medication Chandraprabhavati, which is not mentioned here. Chandraprabhavati is given, and to correct the cycles, as she came to us with the 3 months amenorrhea, but no pregnancy. Grav index was negative, and there is no, but the endometrium is of 6 mm. thickness. So here first she was given the Raja Pravartin Vati and a preparation called the Raja RP Churnam, Raja Pravartaka Churnam, Dashamul Arishta and Aloes compound. First we have started this, and after having these medicine 15 to 16 days she got the menstrual cycle. After that she was asked to undergo take the Panchakarma therapy. So here in the second cycle she was given the Kanchanara Gugulu, Dashamala Arishta and Aloes compound, Chandraprabhavati together. And Apankal Chandraprabhavati, that is a Apankal given Chandraprabhavati is able to correct the Vata Vaigunyas, Apan Vata Vaigunyas. It's a very good acting. So it resulted in the next cycle in time. Means with a gap of 32 days, she got the cycle and normal flow. So we advised her to go for the take the Panchakarma therapy. So Yogabhasi was given for one cycle, that is a Dhanvantaram Thailam and Dashmola Kashayam. And the next cycle is observed. She got the normal cycle and with the regular dates. After that, she was advised to take the Uttarbhasi. Three cycles of Uttarbhasi was given to the patient with the Balathailam. 101 Avartita Balathailam, three cycles of Uttarbhasi was given to the patient. Later she got the two cycles normal, and in the third successive month she got conceived. Here you can see. Now she is in a 21 weeks. This is a 2 weeks back report. So here now she is in a 21 weeks. Next, this is a patient with a 25 years primary infertility and 5 years. She was having she went for the allopathic treatment, but she was not interested to take the hormonal therapies, and there is a disturbance in the menstrual cycles, irregular and delayed menstrual cycle she was suffering since 1 year. So she came directly to the Ayurvedic treatment. So PCOD and TORCH positive are the major findings seen here, and the treatment given to the patient is the Brahmi Vati Aloes compound, Raja Pravartini Vati, Dashamul Arishta in the first month. In the second month, Chandraprabhavati, Garbhadharini Vati, Brahmi Vati Aloes compound and Dashamul Arishta, and TORCH test was done. It's a TORCH positive case in the second month. So started the TORCH nil in the second month. Later in the third month, she was planned for the Yogabhasi. One cycle of Yogabhasi with Dhanvantara Thailam and Dashmola Kashayam given, and second cycle of Yogabhasi was given with the Kshirabala Thailam and Dashmola Kashayam. And in the third cycle, she was planned for the Uttarbhasi. One cycle of Uttarbhasi with 101 Avartita Bala Thailam, she conceived and she delivered also. This is a one more case, interesting case. This patient underwent IVF, IUI three times, laparoscopy, hysterolaparoscopy, etc. All are done, and IVF if also she undergone IVF also, but there's no result. With that, hormonal therapy received by the patient got disturbed the menstrual cycle and approached for the Ayurvedic treatment, and with the complaints of irregular cycles, leukorrhea, and on going through the file, these are the findings, that is a PCOD, endometrial insufficiency, TORCH positive. So here she was treated in the first cycle with the Raja Pravartini Vati and Raja Pravartaka Churnam, Dashamul Arishta, Aloes compound. In the second cycle she was given Garbhadharini Vati, Aloes compound, Dashamul Arishta and Chandraprabhavati. And she was planned for the Yogabhasi in the third cycle. The one cycle of Yogabhasi was given with the Dhanvantaram Thailam and Dashmola Kashayam. And one cycle is given with the Kshirabala Thailam and Dashmola Kashayam. And Uttarbhasi, two cycles of Uttarbhasi was given with the 101 Avartita Bala Thailam. After that, she got a regular menstrual cycle once, and she got conceived and she delivered also. And this is one more case. So here she delivered. So this is a previous report. Now she got delivered also. And this is a one more case with a 34 years of age, primary infertility with a 1.5 year late marriage. This is a 1.5 year marital life. She came to us with a leukorrhea, pelvic pain, dyspareunia. advised the USG, here are the findings. Right ovarian cyst, hemorrhagic cyst, 35 into 32 mm, and the bulky cervix is noted. The patient is treated with the Gokshiradi Gugulu, Varunadi Kashayam, Pushyanuga Churnam and Garbhadharanivati for one cycle. And one cycle of Yoga Basti was given with the Dhanvantaram Thailam and Dashmola Kashayam plus Varunadi Kashayam together. So in the next month, you can see the cyst is disappeared and she conceived and she delivered also. So here you can see the hemorrhagic cyst, which is not seen in the next month scan, and by the next following month she conceived and delivered. And this is a one more case of 25 years age, secondary infertility. The first pregnancy was she got aborted. She came to us with the irregular menstrual cycles, and on USG it is observed that the PCOD and ovarian cyst, she complained of a leucorrhea, irregular menstrual cycles and torch positive case. After that she was treated with a Dashamolarishta, torch nil capsules, Rajapravartini Vati and aloes compound in the first cycle. In the second cycle, Kanchanara Gugulu, Dashamularishta, aloes compound, Garbhadharini Vati, and in the third cycle she was given the Kanchanara Gugulu, Garbhadharini Vati, aloes compound and Phalasarpi and Dashamularishta. And she was given the Yoga Basti of one cycle with the Dhanvantaram Thailam and Dashmola Kashayam, Uttar Basti for one cycle, that is with the 101 Avardita Baladela. She got conceived. You can see the report here. Simple ovarian cyst and PCOD pattern, and here the single intrauterine pregnancy of 8 weeks in the March. Now she is carrying, and this is a one more case of 35 years age. This patient is of primary infertility patient, having the bilateral tubal blockage and torch positive. She is a known case of diabetes mellitus, hypothyroidism, and she was planned for the Uttar Vasti for the four cycles. Here she was given the four cycles of Uttar Basti, that is the first three cycles are given with the Kshara Thailam to clear the tubal blockage, and the fourth cycle was given with the 101 Avartita Bala Thailam to compensate the corrosive action of the Kshara Thailam which is previously given. So here she was advised to go for the HSG again in the 5th month, but luckily, fortunately, she got conceived in the 5th month. She missed the period and she got conceived and she delivered a beautiful female baby. And this is one more slide of 26 years. She is an agriculture BSc officer. She is an agriculture officer and she suffered with the TB endometritis and used 9 months AKT therapy. And she was having the bilateral tubal blockage with the two cycles of the Uttar Basti, and the oral medication, that is a Kanchanara Gugulu, Torchinil capsules, Dashamularishta, Chandra Prabhavati was given to the patient. After two cycles, with the enthusiasm, she went to the USG, HSG again. You can observe the right tube is opened. Later, she came again and she took the Uttar Basti of the further two cycles. Later she got conceived and she delivered. Now one more case is of 28 years. There is no specific medical history and there is no ovulation problem. So ovary was also quite normal and with a regular cycle. So, but the patient has got the bilateral tubal blockage with the two cycles of Uttar Basti with the Kshara Thaila. After that, as she is working in a diagnostic center, she went for the HSG in the third month itself. You can observe the two tubes got opened, so they restored the tubal pattern. See, so that after that she got conceived and she delivered a male baby. Both are fine. And the next is the, you can see this is the case, laparoscopic report of this patient of 30 years age, and she was suffering with the endometriosis and pelvic adhesions and having the bilateral tubal blockage. You can see here. So she was given the three cycles of Uttar Basti, two cycles with the Kshara Thaila she was given and one cycle with the Bala Thaila. After that she was asked to go for the HSG. You can see the both tubes got opened, the restoration of the patency of the tubes you can see, and blockage is cleared. Later she conceived in the successive third month and got delivered also. And this is a one more case of 32 years having the polycystic ovarian disease with the bilateral tubal blockage. Three cycles of Uttarbasi was given to this patient with the Ksharatela, and the fourth cycle was planned with the Ballatela. But on the fourth cycle, in the fourth cycle, she went for the HSG, and you can see the bilateral tubal patency is restored, blockage is cleared. Later, after the 3 months, she got conceived. And here one more case of the 25 years. This is a no specific medical history, but with a marital life of 6 years. So the bilateral tubal blockage was there. She couldn't get concealment. So that she was planned, given the two cycles of Uttarbasi, as she belongs to the medical field. She works in the medical field. With the oral medication, the two cycles of Uttarbasi was given with the Ksharatela. You can see the next slide. The both tubes are got opened. The patency is restored. After the 4 months of this therapy, she received one more Uttarbasi with the 101 Avartita Ballatela. After the successive 2nd month, she got conceived. Now she delivered also. This is a one more case of the 24 years with a right tubal blockage and PCOD. She was given the oral medication Kanchanara Gugulu, Aloes Compound, Garbhadharani Vati, Chandraprabha Vati, and Dashamularishta. And she was given the one cycle of the Yoga Bhasi also with the Dhanvantara Thailam and Dashamula Kashayam. Later she was given the 3 cycles of the Uttarbasi with the oral medication. You can see the right tube is also got opened. So here, these all are the cases. So apart from this, when it is observed that while treating the infertility patient, first the doctor must have the patience, and at the same time it is observed that in cases of complaints of the local, that is a vaginitis, leucorrhea, dyspareunia, itching, burning, etc., whatever may be the infectious conditions locally seen, should be corrected first. After that, it is observed in non-ovulatory cycles the Yoga Basti works very good. If you see the advantages of the Basti, the Basti restores the normal functionings of the Vata, and it mitigates the Vata which is aggravated, and it enhances the functioning of the senses, it gives the psychological balance, and it strengthens the body and maintains the chances of fertility, increases the chances of fertility. And the Ksharatela is observed because of its properties, because of its sukshmatma, vyavayi, vikasi, guna, and saratva. It can penetrate into the channels, and it because of the Kshaaranadva Kshara, because of its property, it clears the blockage. So in the tubal blockage, when the Kshaaratela is given, it is observed in 2 cycles or the 3 cycles of the Kshaaratela Uttarbasti, the tube restores the patency, and the tubal blockage is cleared. And to compensate, to correct the corrosive action of the Kshaaratela, which is given in the previous cycles of Uttarbasti, we have to plan the Ballatela Uttarbasti in the next cycle. So here, and in Yoga Basti, when it is in irregular menstrual cycles, when the cycles are delayed, Yoga Basti works very good. And in non-ovulatory cycles, in such cases also, the Yoga Basti results very good. As we studied that the ovulation and the grahana of the ovum and fertilization, these all are under the control of the proper functioning of the Vata. So Vata is brought to its prakrita status, and restoring the normalcy of the Vata, making its proper functions, it results in the chances of increased fertility rate. So here, I would like to conclude that this Yoga Basti and the Uttarbasti, which are stated here, shows a very positive significant results in achieving the success in the treatment of the female infertility. Though the line of treatment for the infertility women was explained as a snehana swedana vamana virechan asthapana anuvasanaihi, it is observed in the practice that vamana is good, virechana is better, and vasti is the best considered, because the infertility in those three doshas are involvement, the major role is played by the Vata.
So that's why correction of the vata, making the vata into its proper, bringing the vata into its proper state, and means in prakruta state, automatically gives an idea and gives an idea of treatment as well as the success in the treatment. So this is the condition. And in practical, if we look, if you want to explain to the patient, under five headings first we have to explain. That is, the causes of infertility could be the five. That is the sperm and the ovum, first cause. Second is the endometrium, that is a bed for the growing embryo. The zygote comes and stays there and implanted there. So the good endometrium, sufficient thickness and healthy endometrium is required. And the third is the hormones. Explain them the necessary hormones in the necessary levels should be available in the blood to get the ovulation, to conceive, to maintain the conceptional product, to carry forward for the 9 months. And the fourth is tubes. The tubal patency is very essential to achieve the conception. And the last one is psychology. So as psychological status leads to the hormonal psychological balance, leads to the hormonal balance, which is very essential to maintain the all the prakruta, means to maintain the normalcy in all the functions, that is the preparation of endometrium and ovulation and conception and the conceptional product to be maintained and carry forward of the pregnancy. These all are under the control of the hormones. So these are plays very important role. So ask them psychologically, be prepared them and give assurance. Psychological counsel also works very good in irregular cycle and in menorrhagia, metrorrhagia, etc. complaints. We should advise the diet to the patient, proper diet. In irregular cycles, Arthava Janana, such as a Tila, Anatham Sova, Sesamum, Anatham Sova, and regularly we'll see the pineapple, kiwi fruits, bitter gourd and hing. These all are the Arthava Jananas. Ask the patient to take them, because the irregular cycles, delayed cycles can be corrected with the medication, and it will be supported by the result will be as early as possible with the consumption of the proper diet also. In menorrhagia, metrorrhagia cases, all the patients are advised to take the Sheetha Dravyas. And for as it is advised, the Tila, Masha and Taila, which are very essential for the concealment, told by the ancients. This is also should be explained to the patient. And the locally, whatever may be the diseases which are present, should be corrected, should be treated immediately, because the chronicity damages functionally in the particular path and responsible for the causes of the diseases. So, and it becomes a cause for the infertility. So here, with this, I would like to conclude, and I convey my thanks to the team Jignasa, and I would like to thank Dr. Sridhar Anishetty, who helped me a lot in the preparation of this presentation. And I would like to thank all my elders and my teachers who made me to stand here, my parents. And with this, I'll end. Thank you. Thank you very much.